I can't trust my own mind.
You are free.
So until they figure out how to get this stuff out of my head, I think going back under is the best thing. For everybody. I'm with you to the end of the line, pal.
Thank you for this.
Your friend and my father, they were both victims. If I can help one of them find peace.
You know, if they find out he's here, they'll come for him.
Let them try.
Wipe your blunders around like a victory fly.
My blunder sent Tywin's mad dog scurrying back to Casterly Rock with his tail between his legs. I think King Robb understands we're not going to win this war if he's the only one winning any battles. Now, there's glory enough to go around.
It's not about glory.
Tell Lord Tywin. Winter is coming for him.
And in the winter, we must protect ourselves.
20,000 Northerners marching south to find out if he really does shit gold.
King in the North.
King in the North.
Neither Joffrey nor any of his men shall set foot in our lands again. If he disregards this command, he shall suffer the same fate as my father. Only, I don't need a servant to do my beheading for me.
You don't have to do this yourself. Your father would understand
if I... My father understands mercy when there is room for it. Tywin Lannister has my sisters. How many men did you lose?
208. But for every man we lost, the Lannisters...
We need our men more than Tywin needs his!
I am doing something. I'm keeping this group together, alive. I've been doing that all along, no matter what. I didn't ask for this. I killed my best friend for you people, for Christ's sake. I know it looks bad. We've all been through hell and worse, but at least we found each other. I wasn't sure. I really wasn't, but we did. We're together. We keep it that way. There's got to be a place, not just where we hole up, but we fortify. Hunker down. Pull ourselves together. Build a life for each other. I know it's out there. We just have to find it.
Everyone who's alive right now. Everyone who's made it this far. We've all done the worst kinds of things just to stay alive. But we can still come back. We're not too far gone. We get to come back. I know. We all can change.
My name is Robert Neville. I'm a survivor living in New York City. I am broadcasting on all AM frequencies. I will be at the South Street Seaport every day at midday when the sun is highest in the sky. If you are out there, if anyone is out there, I can provide food. I can provide shelter. I can provide security. If there's anybody out there, anybody, please, you are not alone.
Every single person that you or I has ever known is dead! Dead!
I think this is why you're here.
They're just running.
They're
coming.
They're not gonna stop. They're not gonna stop. Stay until dawn.
Sir Alistair fought bravely, it is true. And when he was wounded, it was John who saved us. He took charge of the wall's defense. He killed the Magna of the Fens. He went north to deal with Mance Rayder, knowing it almost certainly meant his own death.
Jon Snow avenged the Red Wedding. He is the White Wolf. The King in the North.
The King in the North!
Mormon himself chose Jon to be his steward. He saw something in Jon, and now we've all seen it too. He may be young, but he's the commander we turned to when the night was darkest.
He is the first to make allies of wildlings and northmen. He was named Lord Commander of the Night's Watch. He was named King in the North. Not because of his birthright. He has no birthright. He's a damn bastard. All those hard sons of bitches chose him as their leader because they believe in him.
None of this would have happened if you had just listened to me!
No, this is where you zip it, all right? The adult is talking. What if somebody had died tonight? Different story, right? Because that's on you. And if you died, I feel like that's on me.
I just want him to be like you.
And I wanted you to be better.
This is all my fault, me.
I should have just listened to Strange and let him send me.
You did the right thing. They would have been killed. You did the right thing.
It's not my responsibility, me.
Oh. What Norman said? My moral mission. No.
No, Peter,
listen. You listen to me. You have a gift. You have power. And with great power, there must also come great responsibility.
My Uncle Ben was killed. It was my fault. I lost Gwen, she was my MJ. I carried on, tried to keep going, tried to keep being that friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, because I know that's what she would have wanted, but I got rageful. I got bitter. I just don't want you to end up like me. She told me that with great power comes great responsibility.
Wait, what? How do you know that?
Uncle Ben said it. The day he died. Maybe she didn't die for nothing, Peter.